Oh, and they're going to say that it was intentional grounding.
53-yard field goal try will be short by Wilkins. So the Cowboys hold and take over.
إذا أردتم مشاهدة روعة الأداء، لحظات النصر ونشوة الفوز، هذه فرصتكم. الدوري السعودي يبث حاليا على أرض.
I'm embarrassed to be seen with you.
Hello? Yeah, hello? Look what I got. Is this crazy or what? Oh my God, you got one too!
Yeah. We are strong!
That 80s show, coming soon, only on Super Comedy.
It's Wild Card Weekend. Saturday on ABC at 4:30 Eastern. We'll be in Tampa Bay as the Redskins face the Bucks. Saturday at 8 o'clock, Jacksonville at the defending champion New England Patriots. Sunday on Fox, 1 o'clock game, Carolina and the New York Giants. And Sunday on CBS at 4:30, Pittsburgh and Cincinnati. Keep your clickers handy all weekend. Jones, who has had no success and gets leveled again by Little. Holy cow, they're just killing Julius Jones.
Leonard Little has been doing this the entire game, and so has the defensive line and linebackers. What they're doing is they're playing rush defense, and they're going at the running back first. Take a look at this. They're going... This is Jones. Jones had 10 yards in the first half, and there's a reason for it. These guys are on their way to the quarterback, and they're going through the running back to get there. Jones doesn't have a chance.
13 carries for 12 yards, and it would be nice if somebody blocks Leonard Little. That was really close to being a lateral, and they can't even help Julius Jones if they get him the ball outside because Tino Isamoah is right there.
The problem is Julius Jones is not an intended receiver on this play. They want to fake a toss, come back, throw a screen to the left, and Drew Bledsoe's looking around the field. He knows where everybody is. He figures, all right, I'll just get it out of my hands into his.
I wonder what guys missed tackles, because that guy, Tino Isamoah, doesn't. He hadn't missed one.
Leonard Little hasn't missed any either. Third and long, Bledsoe goes to the gun. Throws underneath. That is enough for a first down as Creighton. A great hustle play. Got to the sticks and has a first down.
Wow, third down and 17. You complete a 6-yard route, and the receiver runs for 11 yards. Again, Drew Bledsoe surveying the field, gets it out. Now, Patrick Creighton, he just takes off and runs. You know, Terry Glenn just gets in the way enough so that he creates a shield on DeJuan Gross, and there's no play on him.
So the Cowboys in Rams territory at the 47. And now they'll give the toss to Marion Barber, but the officials blow the play dead.
False start, offense, number 65. 5-yard penalty remains first down.
Andre Garrod, let's check in with Susie.
Mike, everybody knows that Bledsoe and Parcells were reunited this year, but what a difference 10 years makes to a relationship. When Bledsoe was 21, he said he looked forward to Sunday just so he could get out on the field and away from Parcells, who was constantly yelling at him. Today, it's about trust. Parcells listens to Drew. Back in the day, Parcells believes they clashed because his upbringing included that confrontation. Drew was raised in a much different environment, and the styles were a rough mix, but not anymore.
All right, Susie, here's the draw play. Barber, the rookie out of Minnesota. A good run, but another flag is down.
Mike, you know, also about Drew Bledsoe, Susie talking about a different environment growing up in.
Holding, offense, number 19. 10-yard penalty Repeat. First down.
That's on Keyshawn, and Jeremy Callahan, the rookie defensive lineman, had to limp off.
Drew's dad, Mac, has been involved in a parenting clinics all throughout the country for a number of years now. It's also his 60th birthday, and he's here tonight with Drew. But it's been a very loving, caring situation, and that's what he goes out and does, has been for the last 8 years. And Drew sort of sponsored the foundation to go out and really teach parents how to be able to nurture young men and young women.
So many of these guys do an awful lot of good through the foundations that they have set up, and they give their own time to it too. Good hard running by Barber. He has found a couple of holes that Jones was unable to find.
So many of these plays being made by the St. Louis Rams are one-on-one tackles. These are the ones that they've been missing. You see the guys stick their head in and make plays.
Now, Bill Parcells really likes Marion Barber. He said he's got a chance to be a real good running back for a long time. Maybe not a star, but a real good back for a long time. Witten goes in motion. Bledsoe, that one's tipped off to the fingertips of Witten and nearly picked off by the Rams.
Oh, we got a wave. Jason Witten, this ball, look at this, goes right off his hands. Here is a catch that he makes 9 out of 10 times.
I had a little mustard on it. Drew let that one fly.
Well, he saw a linebacker sitting in there, and he knew he had to get the ball to Jason Witten in a hurry.
From the 47, it's 3rd and 10.
This is usually where Keyshawn Johnson is called upon to make a big play.
He's in the slot to the top of your screen. Rams show blitz, and here they come.
Oh, man.
And down goes Bledsoe, blindsided by Hargrove.
Nobody touched Hargrove.
Too many people. Not enough blockers.
Yeah, they just sent too many people. And the worst part about it, here's a crowd that's making all this noise when the offense is on the field, when they should be shutting up.
Bill Parcells says Bledsoe is so tough, it is ridiculous. He never complains about being pounded when the protection breaks down. Furry is deep. Takes it on the run at the 25, gets up near the 30-yard line. Good 12-yard return by the converted wide receiver who was now the starting safety for the Rams defense.
أجمل اللحظات الرياضية خلال يناير على أوربت. الدوري السعودي يستحوذ على كامل انتباهكم من خلال تغطيتنا الخاصة. عمالقة كرة القدم الأمريكية يصفون حساباتهم في التصفيات النهائية. متصدر الدوري الهولندي يتأهبون للعودة إلى أرض المعركة. نجوم السلة الأمريكية يتابعون تحليقهم الدائم. وبعد استراحة المحاربين يستأنف الدوري الفرنسي نشاطه بطاقة متجددة. يلتقي المنتصرون والخاسرون في الاحتفال النهائي لبطولات كرة القدم الأمريكية للجامعات. ويبلغ الحماس ذروته مع فعاليات بطولة دبي للرياضات الخطيرة إكس جيمز 2005 برعاية ماونتن دو. أوربت خلال يناير عالم من الرياضة.
Yards receiving he had that night. You would have thought at some point they would have decided to put two guys on him or three.
Jim
but
Everett,
they didn't.
Jim Everett had a night too, throwing it to him.
Bruce makes the catch on a nice comeback route.
Speaking of great Ram receivers, there's one. Well, Isaac Bruce, he's been the teacher for so many of these young guys. Kevin Curtis, Dane Looker. Of course, Torrey Holt gives Isaac a lot of credit for all the things that he has learned from him, the work ethic, the studying of the film.
He only needs three more catches, and he will pass Henry Ellard and Shannon Sharp on the all-time list. This guy's been a great one. Tell you what, both of these defenses have stepped up and just drilled people. That was Keith Davis who took Arlen Harris and planted him.
You know what we're seeing tonight? We're seeing defensive backs, and when they make a commitment, Davis is the guy number 29. Watch when he makes a commitment. They're just unloading. They're not going in there and breaking down and waiting for the runner to come out. Watch how quick he just bang. They don't even hesitate.
Davis, a first-year starter at safety out of Sam Houston State. Tonight's game, not for the faint of heart. Martin, almost a circus catch by Holt. Two flags are down in the secondary. That ball looked like either it was tipped or slipped out of the hand of Jamie Martin.
It was like a push throw slipped. I'd like to have it back. No go forward pass.
And almost a spectacular
catch. Two fouls against the defense. Illegal contact. Defense number 33. This penalty has been declined. Illegal contact. Defense number 26. This penalty is accepted. 5 yards. Automatic first down.
Aaron Glenn called for the foul. Nathan Jones, the same penalty, and that was declined.
Well, if I'm Aaron Glenn, I've gone over and I say, well, why not call on him? Here they are. There's one early, and then Glenn grabs hold of Torrey Holt going out.
That's one of the things the officials emphasized. If you grab a jersey and it's seen that it's being pulled, you're going to get a flag.
Martin, a little sidearm shot to Hedgecock. Hedgecock at the 45. Let's go to Susie.
Mike, with Cowboys owner Jerry Jones. Jerry, Bill Parcells hasn't committed either way, retiring or staying. Assuming tomorrow will be a coaching frenzy in the NFL, what kind of plan do you have to make?
Well, I think that in 3 years, we've got a heck of a start with Bill. And we work together great. He's very passionate. He's got a lot of energy. And so I hope that we can continue what we've got started here.
What kind of timetable would you be comfortable with knowing?
Well, I think we've both said and agreed that we shouldn't talk about this until our season's over. And that starts tomorrow. And it's likely that anything we do probably take about 15, 20 minutes.
What lengths would you go to ensure him staying longer?
Well, I don't know that. Are you negotiating for him?
Maybe.
He's got a good negotiator. But still, I think that we both recognize that we've got something good, that we're pleased with how it's building, but we've got more work to do, and that should be enough to keep both our eyes on the ball.
Everyone was so curious about what the relationship would be like, the guy from Arkansas and the Jersey guy. What has worked?
Well, I think we both want to win, and we both want to win a Super Bowl. I have a lot of respect for his experience, and he's got great people skills, a lot of fun to work with. And so I think all of those things really make it interesting for me to go to work.
You've been such a great judge in business. If you had to put a percentage on it that Bill Parcells would be the coach of the Cowboys next year, what would you say?
Well, I don't want to do that, and shouldn't do that, because I don't want to be presumptuous. But he's done a really outstanding job, and we've got something, as I mentioned earlier, going good here that works. And but we need to keep it going.
How'd you deal with a day like today?
This is the strangest day I've ever had in the NFL. When we came out here, I always can't even stand it on game day. I'm so excited. But it was a downer when we saw those clubs not do something for us that we should have taken care of earlier.
Thanks for coming down to talk to us.
Susie, thanks very much. Third and long, and Terrence Newman will make sure it's not a first down as he gets the tackle on Torrey Holt, his fourth grab of the night.
I can't remember doing a game where defensive backs have unloaded as much as they have tonight. I'm talking on both teams.
Yeah, it's been a lot of one-on-one, and really for the Rams, it's been their Achilles heel. It's been the tackling of their secondary that has been an issue. But you're right, Paul, tonight, both sides, once a guy gets a hold of somebody, they're not letting him go.
Barker to kick to Newman. Back to the 15. And he's nailed as he gets it back to the 20-yard line. 43-yard punt and only a 5-yard return. We're in Dallas, and we'll be back after this.
المركز الرياضي برنامج يحجز لكم تذكرة شبه يومية إلى المحافل الدولية. بوابة للحوار حول الأحداث والقضايا الرياضية. خدمة إخبارية متميزة تضعكم دائما في الصفوف الأمامية. المركز الرياضي يبث من الاثنين إلى الجمعة مباشرة على الرياضية.
Heaven and hell, right? Behind every wall, every window. The world behind the world. We're smack in the middle.
A lone soul wanders between good and evil.
This world is mine.
I don't believe in the devil.
You should. He believes in you.
Seeking his own peace.
Welcome to my life.
At whatever cost.
You sure about this?
No.
Keanu Reeves.
Why me, Gabriel?
Because of the life you took.
Is Constantine, now showing exclusively on TV Max.
Texas Stadium in Dallas. They will have a new facility here in the 2009 season. Cowboys take over just shy of their own 20. Barbara on a little swing. Good hard run up over the 25 near the 28-yard line where Chiller makes the tackle.
Now listening to Susie talk to Jerry Jones and the future of Bill Parcells, and I think we all sort of agree we'd love to see Bill come back. I think yes. He has built an excellent foundation. Drew Bledsoe is 33 years old, and really the biggest problem that Jerry's had since Troy Aikman left is who's going to be the quarterback. They have one now, but he's not the youngest guy. I still think that's an issue that needs to be addressed, not only for this team, but around the league in a lot of places.
You know, for the people who criticized Jerry Jones for being an owner who was really involved with his football team, if you're going to do that, then you have to turn around and give him all the credit in the world for being a guy who was giving it to Bill Parcells.
Holding.
And say,
defense number 79, 5-yard penalty will be added to the end of the run, automatic first down.
Here's your circumstance. You want to run this ball club. You want to produce. I want to win. I'm going to write the checks. And he's written huge checks for signing bonuses and given Bill Parcells the tools he needs.
I think you have a very similar situation with Dan Snyder and Joe Gibbs in Washington, D.C.
Exactly.
Both of these men were maligned for being meddlesome and too involved. Then they went out and found the people that they wanted to run the organizations, and they've let the football people do their job. And you're right, Mike. If you're going to criticize them for what they did, you also have to praise them for their decisions now. But they work in concert. Both Joe and Dan do it, and Jerry and Bill do it.
Newman is in as a wide receiver again. I just love his playmaking skills, and he gets it on the reverse. Got away from Leonard Little, but there are other Rams waiting for him. Trev Faulk pushes him out of bounds.
You know, Joe, you're talking about Drew Bledsoe being 33 and, you know, two-year deal to go, and where you're going to go and behind him. You're looking at how many, 32 teams in the National Football League?
Yep.
There are probably 20 teams that don't even have a quarterback.
No, I agree.
I mean, when you look at throughout the league, where are you going to go and get another guy? Be happy that, I mean, I know you're not being critical about it, but be happy you have Drew Bledsoe and you've kept him healthy, and he's been healthy throughout
saying,
his entire
happened,
career.
You're building this franchise. What happens if he gets nicked? How many guys have you seen go down, Paul?
Yeah, you're right. You don't have anybody behind him.
The backups right now are Tony Romo and Drew Henson, and neither one of them has gotten any playing time.
Now, you know, we talk about these are the guys that have played between Troy Aikman, the Hall of Famer, and Drew Bledsoe. Quincy Carter, Anthony Wright, Clint Stoner, Ryan Leaf, we've seen that act, Chad Hutchinson, Vinny Testaverde, and Drew Henson. I mean, Tony Romo is another guy that's on the roster, but you look at this particular list and you really have to say to yourself, where is the future?
Somebody once said the future is now. And now we'll take you to the fourth quarter. That's our future.
For the first time ever, the ESPN X Games head to the Golden Shores of Dubai. The world's most recognized ex-athletes take their bag of tricks to the Middle East. Have no fear of the X Factor. Catch all the top moments of this unique event. The ESPN X Games 2005, presented by Mountain Dew, Friday at the following times on Orbit ESPN.
جديدة. موسم جديد والكثير من الأفلام الجديدة التي ستبهركم في يناير على تي في ماكس.
And we know it.
تمتعوا بشعر مليء بالكثير من المرح والكوميديا الساخرة لاستقبال السنة الجديدة. فهل تريدون الانضمام؟ Spanish. Dilcho Bikai. Closer.
We're gonna go have some fun, Miles.
Sideways.
It's your time.
First Daughter. Bobby Jones, Joke of Genius.
Hey, Daddy.
Little Black Book.
You're out!
Wara.
Dodgeball.
أقوى الأفلام وأشهر النجوم حصرياً على تي في ماكس. لا يمكنك أن تفوت الفرصة. أليس كذلك؟
No.
Sony, Fox, MGM, Warner, Paramount. أضخم الأفلام من استوديوهات هوليوود في يناير على تي في ماكس. صالة عرضكم المنزلية.
Saturday, the NFL playoffs start with Wild Card Saturday on ABC. Doubleheader coverage at 4:30. Redskins against the Bucs continues with Game 2 at 8 Eastern. The Jaguars against the Patriots on ABC, the home of Super Bowl 40.
I'm looking forward to seeing Coach Gruden again.
I love him on the sideline.
Well, he's one of those guys you just love to be around.
Yep.
Man, he's terrific.
Defense really been dominating this game. Keyshawn stepped out of bounds near midfield. DeJuan Gross couldn't get there in time.
Possession receiver, and he epitomizes it. Keyshawn Johnson finds the hole. Watch this. Boom, outside. Short gain. I got it. I'm out. You're not hitting me.
You know, Keyshawn Johnson was a guy who was asked not to come to work down in Tampa. Very similar situation we've seen with Terrell Owens. And you have to wonder a little bit, where's he going to want? What football team could he potentially athletically make better? Certainly Keyshawn has helped the Cowboys tremendously here.
Two more catches, Joe, and he will crack the NFL's all-time top 20. And the running game just not going anywhere. We asked Keyshawn how he is a Bill Parcells guy.
He told me the other day I'm a lot like him, which is probably true. I am. I'm a lot like him. Yeah, I could scream at the kicker and I could yell at a player and get into a confrontation a lot like he does. But that's because you have the enthusiasm, the will to want to win and do better and be a champion. And a lot of people don't understand and know what that is. They talk it in lip service, but they don't know how to deliver it on the football field or in the locker room or in the meeting room or how to inspire the other guy how to play.
And Bill has really never had a problem with Keyshawn, outspoken and all. Bledsoe overthrows Witten, who had beaten Furry and was open near the sideline.
Well, I'll tell you, this is one time where Drew Bledsoe saw some real dark blue shirts, and they were coming. Witten was open, but he couldn't set himself to make the throw.
That's one of those balls you'd love to have back.
I tell you, every time a guy throws an interception or a bad pass, they'd like to have it back.
Well, there's the difference. Witten pulls up, and Drew thought he was going to keep on going. I'm surprised they didn't
throw the flag.
That's intentional.
Intentional grounding?
Isn't that intentional grounding in this game?
No, there was a guy in the area.
Oh, I'm sorry. Yeah, but he stopped. Went over his head.
Terrence Cooper, number 18,
they
checks
come.
In.
They're all coming.
Here comes the blitz. Little. Oh, their ball's loose. There is a flag down. Leonard Little, who has been all over the Cowboys offense.
Leonard Little tonight would make the Pro Bowl. Just one game. He is just tearing Petitti.
Holding offense number 79. His penalty has been declined. The recovery to St. Louis. First down.
Rob Petitti, he doesn't have a chance against Leonard Little. Leonard Little, off the ball, is so quick.
The 12th Ram tackle behind the line of scrimmage. And Leonard Little's been on half of them.
ESPN Sunday Night Football, kind of emotional for the guys upstairs in the booth, which may explain why they were a little out of sorts at the New Year's Eve party last night. We captured it.
There's a certain je ne sais quoi. That's French.
It's more elegant, more poetic, more, dare I say, sexy.
Did you say?
I can't tell you.
Oh, I know you can't.
I can't tell you.
I've got a cup up here, too.
That's great.
That was funny.
That's great.
That was fun doing that.
Suze, we're going to get you. We're going to get you.
Way to go, Suze.
We're going to get you.
Jamie Martin, good protection, throws to the sideline. Incomplete. Tried to get it to Harris. That fumble, the turnover, was the eighth fumble Drew Bledsoe has lost this year. That's the most of any quarterback.
You know what I'm looking at this Ram team for the last three quarters, you know what they're missing? Mike Martz.
Just the
I'm
offensive
telling you, this
side
is an offense that has no Mike Martz influence in it at all.
Yeah, but you know what? In defense of Steve Fairchild, who's taken over for him, Mike Martz implemented plays. Mike Martz is used to calling him. Steve's trying to do the best he can, I think, in keeping this game close. Protect the quarterback and let him get the ball down the field.
Oh! And it's the tight end.
Brandon Montemagliano.
Go ahead.
Montemagliano. Brandon, look at this throw, but the catch is just outstanding. Here, look at this catch, and he knows he's going to get whacked.
Boy, did he ever.
But I think
he's 290. He's abusing people, hitting them. Three guys hit him, and they go like bowling ball.
I was going to say, it looked like bowling pins as they go end over end. Willie Pyle was in there. Harris turns the corner. Harris. The ball comes loose at the goal line. No signal yet.
Now, here's the question. The official, the side judge, almost reached for a flag because did he hit the ground? Was he down before the ball bounced through the end zone for which would have been a touchback?
Ruling him out at the one.
There he is now. He's reaching. Yep. Now.
He's down.
Yep.
That's what they ruled. They have to rule he's down by contact there, and then the ball comes out. It doesn't matter. But I'll tell you what it is. It's a first down.
Sure is. First and goal. And the Rams will use a timeout at the 12-minute mark in this ballgame.
Saturday at the following times on Orbit ESPN.
ESPN Sunday Night Football brought to you by Staples. That was easy. T. Rowe Price, mutual funds, IRAs, college savings from T. Rowe Price. Invest with confidence. Taco Bell Big Bell Value Menu. To get full-on value, think outside the bun. And Kia Motors. Kia, the power to surprise.
You know, I've only been here 8 years and watching the defenses, and you know, with Ray Lewis and all the others. But you know, tonight, Leonard Little is just showing us basically what we've been seeing, what I've been seeing for the last 8 years about defensive players. Just outstanding play.
Arlen Harris into the end zone for his first touchdown of the year, the free agent from Virginia. And it makes you wonder why Marshall Faulk wouldn't be in there down at the goal line in the fourth quarter. Not that Harris did a bad job.
Marshall Faulk has talked about his enjoying the role that he has. Teacher, mentor, part-time runner. Says it's as healthy as he's been in a while.
Did you ever notice in the game Marshall Faulk never has his helmet off? He's always ready to play.
Rams take the lead by 7 over Dallas here in Big D.
إذا أردتم مشاهدة روعة الأداء لحظات النصر ونشوة الفوز هذه فرصتكم الدوري السعودي يبث حاليا على أرض
Looking good from Dallas, 17-10. Rams over the Cowboys on the final regular season telecast on Sunday Night Football.
Took his helmet off, Paul.
Yeah, he takes his helmet off when they're on defense, okay. But he doesn't take it off when they're on offense because he's ready to play.
Tyson Thompson ran through one tackle, got it up to the 33-yard line. 11:50 to go in the ball game. Will the Cowboys come back and win their 10th of the season?
أجمل اللحظات الرياضية خلال يناير على أوربت. الدوري السعودي يستحوذ على كامل انتباهكم من خلال تغطيتنا الخاصة. عمالقة كرة القدم الأمريكية يصفون حساباتهم في التصفيات النهائية. متصدر الدوري الهولندي يتأهبون للعودة إلى أرض المعركة. نجوم السلة الأمريكية يتابعون تحليقهم الدائم وبعد استراحة المحاربين يستأنف الدوري الفرنسي نشاطه بطاقة متجددة يلتقي المنتصرون والخاسرون في الاحتفال النهائي لبطولات كرة القدم الأمريكية للجامعات ويبلغ الحماس ذروته مع فعاليات بطولة دبي للرياضات الخطيرة إكس جيمز 2005 برعاية ماونتن دو أوربت خلال يناير عالم من الرياضة
Ready for some good ball games. The BCS kicks off with Ohio State and Notre Dame in the Fiesta. Georgia, West Virginia in the Sugar. Penn State, Florida State in the Orange on Wednesday. Number one USC against number two Texas for the national championship in the Rose Bowl. All the BCS ball games can be seen on ABC. Jones, first time tonight he's had room to run. To the 40-yard line of the Rams. A 28-yard gallop after being hemmed in the entire game.
Well, I'll tell you, this time here he was not hemmed in. This was a perfect play. They toss to the outside. They just forced the entire Ram defense back out to the outside. And then watch him. He cuts right back inside off his block. Place is alive again.
Jones on the toss. Hit in the backfield. Horse collared and taken down. And now the Dallas fans are going to be upset with that because of the horse collar rule named after Roy Williams.
Well, there's a very specific nature to the horse collar. If you grab the guy and he still runs a little bit, and you don't swing your legs in underneath him, it's not considered a horse collar. And there you saw Julius continue to run. You have to grab in behind the shoulder pads, and Anthony Hargrove has as much speed as Julius Jones.
Hargrove and Little have had big games from those defensive end spots. Bledsoe in a little half roll. Throws to the sideline. Can't hit Creighton. First 20 games, Julius Jones